Joining me now is the football writer David Winner, who wrote the book Brilliant Orange on all things Dutch football. David, thanks so much for joining us. Let's not beat about the bush here. A shambolic campaign from the Netherlands. Why?
Well, I think there are structural problems and also some short-term problems. Short-term problems were that the campaign got off to a rotten start. I think the Dutch were overconfident. We're the third best team in the world, don't you know? So they approached their early games in the qualification rounds with a slightly lackadaisical attitude. Then there were terrible defensive errors. And then panic started to spread, and by the time they realized the predicament they were in, they were beyond help, essentially, and they changed manager, and that didn't do any good either. That's what went wrong in the campaign. But the structural problems are much more deep rooted than that. I think the final in the 2010 World Cup and the third place in the last World Cup last year slightly flattered them. They hadn't been producing the kind of genius players, world's top players that they had been from the 70s through to the 90s, and a little bit in the 2000s. And they currently have a horrendous gap between the young sort of promising players and the old guard, people like Robin van Persie, who scored maybe the best or one of the best goals ever with his head, the best diving header goals in the last year's World Cup, and then tonight scores an absolutely ludicrous, but also in its mad way, a quite elegant, terrible own goal that sort of caps probably his career. That's probably the end of his international career. Guys like Arjen Robben, Wesley Sneijder. So if you look at the starting lineup that Holland had tonight, there was a gap. There were a bunch of players, all young, the oldest of which was 25, and then the old guard, a few old players, aged 31 and up. So there were no mature, good players. And that's a problem with the Dutch development system.